After her performance, including that infamous onstage kiss, Tatiana was all of a sudden dropped and iced out of Jackson's inner circle with no further explanation, leaving Thumbtzen utterly devastated. But what invisible line had she crossed? Did she prove herself to be a traitor, manipulator, or an obsessive fanatic of Jackson? Here is the full detail. While waiting to hear back from Jackson's team about the next dates on the tour, Tatiana returned to LA. Knowing that certain members of Michael's entourage weren't happy with her, Thumbtzen heard that Karen Fay, Michael's makeup artist, started a rumor that the video girl had complained about the service at the hotel and that she had demanded a suite. On April 11th, Thumbtzen appeared on The Tonight Show with host Ross Schaefer. Quote, he asked me, "So are you and Mike really dating?" I replied, "No, we're not. Our relationship is strictly professional." He insisted, "No, come on." I repeated my answer, and once again, he insisted with the point that we were dating. I thought I would add a little humor and some mystery, so I responded by saying, "No, we're not. Not yet, anyway." It got back to me that Michael did not like my response. She recalls, quote, "My dates just went by. A friend calls me and tells me you've been replaced. Sheryl Crow is doing your number, and my world was shattered." Joe Jackson recounted that the onstage kiss was a strike against her, but, quote, "When she spoke on a talk show about her relationship with Michael, Michael's manager decided that that was enough. She was immediately fired. We knew that he had romantic feelings for her, but we certainly did not utter a word about it since it was not clear if this relationship was serious or not." Tatiana Thumbtzen had never been near a celebrity and couldn't believe that someone so famous and in demand would be interested in her. Fiercely protective of his privacy, Tatiana had proven herself to be untrustworthy, having been thrown into the public eye and speaking about such sacred subjects before Michael Jackson had the opportunity to spend some real time with her and gain some insight into her character. Michael Jackson was said to be attracted to women with class, who carried themselves with grace, and crucially, those he felt would be loyal to him. He did not like women who he felt were pushy and aggressive and was put off by those who used their sexuality to seduce men, further their career, and in general, get what they want. After all, he was raised a devout Jehovah Witness, and from his perspective, Thumbtzen had proven herself to be very much like the dangerous women he would sing about. The aftermath. Having lost out on the opportunity and also on Michael, Tatiana was left heartbroken and devastated. In several interviews, the video girl claimed she suffered from hair loss, fell into a deep depression, and even contemplated suicide. Quote, "I went through a great battle with depression. I cried often and extremely hard. Then to top it off, I was bombarded with questions about why someone else was doing my part. Why aren't you out there? All kinds of comments came my way, and it hurts so bad. It got to where I hated leaving my house. I felt as though I did not want to live." Years later, Michael Jackson spoke about the girls who featured in his videos, saying, quote, "I casted them because I really liked them, and it caused a problem afterwards because they start to really like me. When they see me running the other way, some of them follow me around the world, and it is so hard because it would hurt them too much." Thumbtzen maintained contact with Michael's mother, who was also puzzled by what happened. Tatiana was invited to the Jackson compound in Encino, and they talked at length several times. Tatiana rattled her brain trying to come up with an explanation for the sudden cold treatment. Did Michael's handler see her as a threat to the tour, or just a crazed fan? Or was she naive and read into his actions too much? Even so, being fired from the tour had terrible repercussions for her both psychologically and professionally. Unfortunately, being the girl from the MJ video turned out to be a career killer, as casting agents couldn't look beyond it, and she lost a lot of work. To add insult to injury, Thumbtzen also felt taken advantage of when it came to the payment she received for her appearances with Michael Jackson. Quote, "All I was paid was $5,000 for the tour and a little less than that for the video." Having seen her picture on the 45 single of The Way You Make Me Feel, she also heard that Michael Jackson's 1988 calendar had her picture for the month of May. She was perplexed that she was not paid for these additional uses of her image. For a brief period, Tatiana agreed to have Michael's father manage her career. Quote, "He talked about the things I should be doing to capitalize on my success, like having my own clothing line, calendar, or doll. He told me how perfect my face was for a doll and the great success I could have. He promised it would all happen if I stuck with him." However, Joe Jackson suspected that employing him was simply one of her futile attempts to once again catch his son's eye. Quote, "She vainly tried to draw his attention to herself again, but Michael completely kept away from her when he had found out that she dated Prince. Then she moved on to a member of Milli Vanilli, and when that didn't work, even tried to seduce my other son. But these guys never worked out because she was still in love with Michael." When the singer first faced allegations of child molestation in 1993, the Way You Made Me Feel video star appeared on several radio and talk shows, including Howard Stern and Mari Povich, where she lied about having a romantic relationship with Jackson that lasted over 18 months. The Jackson patriarch went on to say, quote, "When the charges against Michael appeared, her money had ended again, and that's why she talked on TV about Michael, but she said such nonsense." Soon after, her former fling Prince approached Tatiana in a nightclub and started talking to her about it. Prince knew her and Jackson's entire story because when she was with him, all she would speak about was Michael. Prince expressed his opinion on her hypocritical behavior. She tried to get out and explained that her words have been twisted, but Prince did not believe her. He accused her of telling lies about Michael for money, when she was the one who could tell the real truth. Over the years, Tatiana Thumbtzen would release two books and partake in countless interviews relating to her short-lived relationship with Jackson. After the King of Pop's death in 2009, Tatiana Thumbtzen attended Michael Jackson's private funeral at Forest Lawn Park. By then, she had not seen Michael in over 20 years. However, she remained friendly with the Jackson family, and Katherine Jackson invited her. But whatever is said about Tatiana Thumbtzen and her relationship with Michael, she was the first woman with whom he physically interacted in front of a camera with. She triggered the notion of desire in Jackson's performance as she reenacted this sexual game on stage at Madison Square Garden with his first ever kiss in public. Their momentary attraction gave Jackson a new sensual and sexual dimension in the eyes of the world. A visual play, captured in celluloid for generations to come. Thank you for watching The Detail. Check out our channel for more Michael Jackson videos and also visit our MJ store by clicking our link in the description. We'll see you next time.